But suddenly things have started changing, and the number of students, even yesterday I mentioned, number of students aspiring to become an MBA graduate is also dwindling. It's coming down because last year the TANSET score, TANSET is the entrance test conducted by Tamil Nadu government, where only 3,000 plus students opted to take up the test for the MBA program. That is one side of the story. On the other side, the corporates which are coming visiting our list of in the first, they come up. Once we give letter, they decline it, sir. They have so this is not used to be. There is a join, and within 3 months or 4 months they quit. The language of the students is not good. So many complaints we have. But this is a time we have to identify what is the real problem, because everything is changing. We have to identify, we have to refine, redefine or reinvent our MBA program. And also we have to do something to motivate our students and the kind that the industry needs, that we have to impart it. Also feels happy when they come to our school that they have recruited the correct students. I hope the visionary statesmen, organizers, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much.
We sincerely thank you, sir, for the vivacious presidential address.
Arriving at one goal, turning point to Dewey, we feel honored to have Professor Dr. R. Saravana Selvan, member of the syndicate, Dean Research, Professor and Head, Department of English and Foreign Languages, Bharathiyar University, to inaugurate the Nexus 2K17.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Most respected and most revered Padma Bhushan Dr. Mrityunjaya Athreya sir, devoted and dedicated Mrs. Vanita Mohan Madam, Professor Dr. Vivekanandan, Director of the BSMAD Department, Professor Ajay Matthew, the Dean, Faculty of Social Sciences, Dr. Rupa Gunasilan, Professor of BSMAD, Mr. Shankar, the President of BSMAD Alumni Association, my colleagues in the department, invitees, friends from various institutions, various places, student friends, research scholars, good morning to you all once again. I'm really happy today to be here. In 1995, when I was doing my postgraduate diploma in teaching English at English and Foreign Languages University, we have a branch of study called stylistic analysis. When I was doing my stylistic analysis course, I came the Mrityunjaya Mantra. Mrityunjaya Mantra, if you go to the Rig Veda and learn that one, or just get the meaning of that one, if you want to conquer death, pronounce Mrityunjaya Mantra. If you want to live successfully with proper health, with good health, Mrityunjaya Mantra is the only source. That's what Rig Veda says, that's what Mrityunjaya Mantra says. And we have Professor Dr. Mrityunjaya, who has given life to several people. He has become the management guru. He has become the source of inspiration, hailing from Tamil Nadu. He has got the prestigious, covetous Padma Bhushan Award, several other awards. This is only the most important one, and several other world-class titles he has got. And he has produced innumerable scholars and students and management personalities, and he is a source of inspiration to all of us. So whether you know the Mrityunjaya Mantra or not, start pronouncing the name of Mrityunjaya, you will become the management gurus. I'm really happy, sir. I'm not flattering you, I really mean that one actually. Next we have Madam Vanita Mohan. The name, meaning for the name is equal to save water and save trees. This is the meaning. There is no meaning. What is the meaning her parents have given, we do not know. with this one organization called Sirudhuli, and we have water, water, water everywhere in almost all the water resources in Coimbatore. But for her single-handed efforts, most of the water resources would have converted into plots. And we would have, see, I was told Gandhivaram town bus stand was once a lake. Gandhivaram town bus stand is once a lake. But today we have the town bus stand. Similarly, several other water bodies would have been converted into the flats or some kind of a commercial thing by several other people. But she was there to protect that one, and now we have almost all the water bodies have got water. And next is trees. She has just now, if you just go to the next campus, now we have the Anna campus. Given now, she has, the Sirudhuli organization has joined with Anna University. They have a beautiful forest there. They've established a forest. Very signed with Sirudhuli. And Adam was there, and shortly we are also going to have the Sirudhuli project in our campus to convert vacant land for thick forest. And now that is the biggest thing. Friends, we all know that when Cape Town, by the month of June, it is not going to have a drop of water. The entire city of Cape Town is not going to have water because persons like Vanitha Mohan are not there in that place. As long as persons like Madam are here, and Coimbatore will never face that kind of a situation. Because Professor Lakshmana Perumalswamy, former head of the Department of Environmental Science, used to say, every tree produces worth around 3 crore of oxygen every year. Every year, each tree produces 3 crore worth of oxygen. Now, just ask her, she might have lost the counting, in number of trees she has planted, and that means, you know, so much of money, so much of crores she has given. Though she is an industrialist basically, and the social cause, so the award which are going to confer her today, the most suitable one, and this, she is the right person, and that's the best choice also. Hearty congratulations, and we are really happy to talk about you, ma'am. Now, friends, why do we have these two great personalities on the stage? Why we have in an alumni meet we have? One simple thing, when we look at the mirror, we appreciate our handsomeness, we appreciate our beauty, we enjoy. Because most of the time, we spend half an hour or an hour in front of the mirrors to comb our hair or decorate or makeup, foundation, brush with or without brush or anything, we do that one for hours together. But these two personalities, they have not been looking at the mirror, they've used the mag world to look beyond. They started looking beyond, not in a mirror. When you look at the mirror, you reflect yourself only, you see yourself only, you become selfish. But these two have not seen their self. They looked beyond using a magnifying glass. That is why they wanted to do everything great, great, great. Professor Athreya has created so many scholars in management, and Madam has just protected the nature. It's only because of her Coimbatore's water level, groundwater level is coming up. And the heat is also coming down because of the trees she has planted personally also. So these two personalities are the source of inspiration. We always take cinema actors and heroes and heroines as the role models. Now they are the sitting and standing examples and role models for us. We need to take that one. And why this alumni meet, my dear friends? Why? This is the only department in this university which is regularly conducting this alumni meet. I'm right, sir. I must heartily congratulate that one, because NAC or several other nodal agencies are insisting on that one. You should track them. See, for when a student passes out of the department, 5 years minimum, you must track them what they are doing. This is the nodal agencies are insisting on that one. But we don't have the mechanism. We don't have the mechanism. Only these kind of forums, you know, can tell us what these people are doing, what the students, what they were doing here. Because we know very well, the alumni are the ambassadors of this university. Once in a year, you must come back. Whether you have a forum or not, you must come back to meet the department, to tell about your growth, to tell about your future plan, and also to know about your university where you studied. Because after all, this is your alma mater. Without this, you are not there. And without you, this institution is not there. Vice versa. So we must join hands. We always say PhD Tech is the best institution in the world and the topmost institute in India. Why? Because the alumni is very, very strong in PhD Tech. It is because of that only the institution is growing like anything. Now, coming to Bharatiya University, you all must be happy to know about this one. This university is growing leaps and bounds. And in H-Index, when you go to the web of science, and just now type Bharathiyar University in web of science, Bharathiyar University is topping in the H-Index with 46. This is topping it one year. And last year, NIR ranking, we enjoyed the 28th rank. And at the world class, we have the 1049th rank. Several achievements are there. Of course, small slips will be there. Small slips only will remind us that you have to strengthen yourself. You must be more cautious. More cautious. Occasional small slips must be there, and only those occasional slips will strengthen you. Men may come and men may go, but the institutions go on forever. So you must carry this kind of a message that the universe is growing and your contribution is also required. And friends, and we have given you the MBA degree. University has given you the MBA degree. Department has given you the MBA degree. And the biggest question we would like to place before you is here, what are the byproducts of this MBA program? If I give you a liter of milk, you can convert the milk into buttermilk or a curd or and butter, ghee or milk sweet. Several byproducts of milk are there. Just 1 liter of milk. Several byproducts of the milk are there. You can add value to that one here. You can convert that 40 rupee milk to 400 rupees also. If you can add value to the milk. Similarly, we have given you 1 liter of MBA degree only. That's all. We have given you MBA degree. What is the value you are going to add to that MBA degree? What are the byproducts of the MBA degree we have given you? And that is why we want to know that one. That's why this alumni association. And that is why this meet. And we want to educate you. We want to learn from you also. So tell us your ideas. Now, Professor Vivekananda rightly touched upon. Just we want to revise the syllabus also. And how to do this one? You are there in the industry, institutions. You just come and give us your idea. Not necessarily in person also. Okay, also you can mail us here. So we will be, unless otherwise we work together, join together, I think the future generation is not growing like anything. We are not going to create like processes like Atreya sir. So friends, coming together is the beginning. Working together is success. We have come together, regularly we are coming together, but the question is, are we working together? Friends, this world, the society is like a hot water. It's a boiling hot water. If you are like a hot potato, the society will convert you into a soft one. If you are like a solid potato, you put it in the hot water, it converts into a soft one. If you are like a liquid egg, the hot water will turn into a solid one. But if you are like a coffee bean, you can convert the hot water into the tastiest coffee, the costliest coffee. Go to Annapurna, a small tumbler of coffee costs 30 rupees. That's nothing but hot water. Hot water has been converted, given so much of taste, so much of flavor, so much of image, and so much of value by the coffee bean. Potato is not changing the water. Hot water is changing the potato. Hot water is changing the egg. But it is only the coffee bean changing the hot water into the tastiest coffee. Or is the coffee bean? My question is there, and answer is very much within you. And you can, this kind of meet will try to get you the answer also. Wish you all the best. With these few words, I happily inaugurate this Nexus. Thanks for this wonderful opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Permanence, perseverance, and persistence. In spite of all obstacles, discouragements, and impossibilities, it is this that in all things distinguishes the strong soul from the weak. Thomas Carlyle. Now, Mr. Manikandan will give us the introduction to the Social Impact Award.
Good morning. It's an honor to be in front of you amidst elite people like Dr. Atreya, Mrs. Vanita Mohan, my teachers here, the registrar in charge, Dr. Sarana Selvan, my friend from BSMED Alumni Association's current president, S.M. Shankar. Now it's an opportunity that they've given me to actually work together with the alumni and the school and to try and bring the corporates together along with the alumni into the BSMED fold and to try and take BSMED to its original track of glory that it was set way back in 1984. When we looked at identifying a methodology to recognize the corporates in Coimbatore, we wanted it to be beyond what is today touted as corporate social responsibility. the city of Coimbatore, the entrepreneurs of Coimbatore who made the city what it is today, actually transcend much beyond the term entrepreneur, CSR, startups. The people of Coimbatore knew the actual meaning of coming together and building an illustrious place like this. Just imagine, way back in 1926, a fifth brother is born in a family in the form of charity. The PSG and Sons Charities was created with a corpus of 2 lakh plus in 1926. Now that is the story of Coimbatore. So we wanted something beyond CSR to be identified with the corporates of Coimbatore. And after a lot of soul searching, we said, let's look at a name called Social Impact. The reason why we froze Social Impact is it transcends beyond corporate social responsibility. And what we see in the entrepreneurs of Coimbatore is not just identifying a cause. It is just that they lead not only from the front, as they have been telling. Mrs. Vanita Mohan has been not instrumental in creating the vision for Sirathulli. She has been part and parcel of the team, planting the trees, desilting the tanks, negotiating with various government organizations so that the 34 odd water tanks that was established in the city of Coimbatore, in and around Coimbatore, is brought back to its original glory. We would like to see all these 34 tanks brimming up to its full, harvesting rainwater so that the people of Coimbatore enjoy the weather that I actually enjoyed when I was a child. When I was going to school, I actually did not know a Coimbatore which had a temperature beyond 35, 36 degrees. Now we are talking about 40 plus being touched. If 40 does not touch, it means the year is not past. And that is what we're talking about. So when we looked at identifying this as an opportunity, we could not find a better name than Social Impact, and the team put together could not find a much, much better person to start this whole process off. Now I take this opportunity to thank each one of you who have gathered here to listen to two illustrious people share their thoughts. And I leave with one message, which I have been taught by my teachers and my friends. Nature actually teaches, and people like Dr. Athreya and Mrs. Vanita Mohan actually help us transform our dream into reality. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
பொலிப்பகல நுட்பநூல் எச்சம் இந்நான்கின் கொளித்தகலம் காட்டாதார் சொற்கள் பழிப்பில் நிறை ஆமா சேர்க்கும் நெடுங்குன்ற நாடா உரையமோ நூலிற்கு நன்கு. பொருள்: நூலை பல வகையில் ஆராய்ந்து உரைப்பவரே அவைக்கு உரியவர் என்பது கருத்து. அவை அறிதல் நாளடியார்.
Society does not consist of individuals, but expresses the sum of interrelations, the relations within which these individuals stand. Now, I call upon on the dais Miss Aishwarya to introduce Miss Vanita Mohan.
It's an immense pleasure that I am to introduce this eminent personality. She comes from the family of industrialists, daughter of the legendary Thiru L.G. Vardarajalu, founder of L.G. Group, an MBA from Strathclyde, Glasgow, Scotland, married to Mr. Vijay Mohan of Premier Mills family. She is currently the chairperson of Precol Limited. Despite being a busy industrialist, her passion towards serving the environment prompted her to initiate the founding of Sirathulli Movement in association with other companies, including LMW, LG, Sri Shankara Eye Society and Bannariamman Group of Companies. Sirathulli has ushered a revolution in changing the environmental landscape of Coimbatore. Perhaps the most noteworthy is the cleaning up of Ukkadam Periyakulam Lake. A spark as an initiative turned out to massive public movement, still magnetic and attracting innumerous volunteers serving the cause. Next on agenda for Sirathulli is the ambitious project of reviving the Noyal River and once lifeline of Kongu region towards its past glory. BSMED takes immense pleasure in conferring the inaugural Social Impact Award to Mrs. Vanita Mohan. There is no better person to receive the award than someone who takes pride in calling a crusader of Mother Nature than a successful businessman. Thank you.
It's a proud moment for all of us to have Ms. Vanita Mohan here on Bharatiya University to honor her with the Social Impact Award. We kindly call upon Dr. Mrityunjay B. Athreya to present the Social Impact Award to Ms. Vanita Mohan, Managing Trustee, Sirutuli Chairperson, Precall Limited.
When environment evokes passion, a stalwart unites a business community for a mission and ignites a way of public compassion, a green revolution is born. Bharatiya School of Management and Entrepreneur Development, BSMED Alumni Association, is proud to confer Social Impact Award to Ms. Vanita Mohan, the Managing Trustee, Sirudhuli and Chairperson, Precall Limited. I request you again to once again to give her a wonderful clap.
Thank you, sir. We extend a heartfelt congratulations to Ms. Vanita Mohan and invite her to present her acceptance speech.
Respected Padma Bhushan Dr. Mrityunjay Athreya, the President of BSMED Alumni Association, Sri Shankar, the other office bearers and the members of the Alumni Association, Dr. Vivekanandan, Director of BSMED, Dr. Saravanan Selvan, other dignitaries on the dais, members of the faculty, ladies, gentlemen, and my young friends. A very good morning to all of you. When the members, especially the president of the Alumni Association of Bharatiya University School of Management, approached me through some influential purpose people, my first response was, no, not at this point in time. Thank you very much. I feel privileged, honored, but we still have a long way to go. So I think it should be reserved for somebody else. But no, their persistence, their insistence, and the way they went around trying to convince, finally he was there to meet me and said, no, I think you'll have to take it. Thank you very much for this honor. It's a great honor, not to me. I dedicate this award to all my team members in Sirutuli who have been relentlessly, it is not a single person's work. I'd like to correct you, Dr. Saravanan Selvan. It is a team effort. This is a great example of what things can happen if committed hearts and hands come together. And that is what we have in our Sirutuli team. I take this opportunity to recognize our Sirutuli team members here, who are here today, our trustee, Dr. Shri Kanaklal, and our other members who have relentlessly worked very quietly while I walk away with all the awards. They are the people whose hearts are constantly beating for the city. And if we have been able to make a difference to the eco landscape of Coimbatore, it's the efforts of all these gentle hearts and gentle souls. I would also like to dedicate this award to my team at Precol, who have also been continuously supporting me in all my efforts. Another entity that I will be failing in my duty if I do not dedicate this award is the solid corporate support, corporate and the business and trade community of Coimbatore through the Chamber of Commerce, who has been solidly backing me up in all our efforts, very silently but very strongly. But for their support, Sirithulli would not be what it is today. After I accepted to participate in today's function, I was dwelling on the part of social impact. Have we really a few water, but not the kind of water that we want, because there's a lot of sewage which is water, the quality of the groundwater. We still have a very, very long way to go. What is the kind of a social impact that we have created? This was a kind of patient that a couple of are seeking. Because until then, I truly felt that we have not created a social impact. Created a social impact. There should be a lot more people, a lot more hands and hearts that should come into the fold of Sirithulli. It was just a coincidence, probably an answer to my prayers. There was a business associate of ours, Coimbatore. He was passing through the Ukkadam tank in a taxi. He told the driver, "Oh, you're in Coimbatore." So the taxi driver, without any hesitation, went back and said, "This is due to an NGO that we have in Coimbatore, Sirithulli." That was an answer coming from a person who is constantly driving people back and forth. For him to turn around and look at a water body and say it is due to the efforts of an NGO, that warmed the cockles of my heart. I started believing, yes, we have made an impact, maybe in a small way, but today's award also a lot to go. We need, I'm sure, in the all of you, so many of you who have been part and parcel of Sirithulli. From the beginning, I would also like to congratulate the Bharathiyar University, because it has been very active at a point when we didn't know where to go. The of Bharathiyar has been very activities, silting, be it tree planting, be it creating awareness that we have been doing among the public, or the waste management, because there's a lot that has to be done as far as waste is concerned. So I take this opportunity to thank Bharathiyar University for being a part of us. And I would also like to thank the Anna University, who's your neighbor, for the tremendous opportunities that they have given us to plant trees. I'm sure all of you know, today, the cost of urbanization, lots of people moving from the villages to the cities, to the metros, to the cities and towns, the first victim is the green cover of the region. And Coimbatore, which used to be a lush green corridor with huge areas dedicated to trees, have all been converted into concrete jungles. Result, today, beginning of March, We are already 40 degrees. I dread to think how it is going to be in April, May. I remember growing up, one of the members of the Alumni Association, he said when he was growing up, I'm sure he's a lot younger than me, he says he had seen a better Coimbatore. What I saw when I was growing up was a Coimbatore which had the Noyal flowing perennially. It was so perennial, there was so much of flow, it was not just a trickle what you see today. It was a perennial gush of water that used to come tumbling down the Western Ghats. So much that my grandmother, you would say, she would constantly make sure that we never went anywhere near the river. That's the amount of water we had. And where has all the water gone? The water has gone because we forgot to respect it. I'm sure many of you would have read about this Japanese analysis that they have done about water responding to emotions. And I think we have forgotten water. We just like to have water when we want it, but the rest of the time it's gone. Water is used as a medium for us to dump our garbage. Water is good. Water is being used as a dump, as a means to let in our sewage, so that our sewage gets diluted and there's not too much of contamination. If you respect water, water will respect you. Yesterday there was Mahathriya from Infinitism who was addressing the CII. He said, if you take up God's work, God will do your work. We have been experiencing this in Sirithuli every step of our way. One step towards Mother Nature, she comes 10 steps towards us. That is something that we have experienced on a daily basis, every moment of our working with nature has given us that kind of experience. So it is not just a handful of people, it's not just a handful of corporates who can probably say, this is my CSR activity. No, taking care of nature, who has been so benevolent, who has been so compassionate to take care of us. Can we think of a single moment when you can live without water or air, which is being given to us free? Every second of our lives, it is being given to us free. Why do we have to take it for granted? Why can't we work for it? Why can't we earn it? It is not about earning money alone. I keep telling my friends, it is like your ATM. It is only when you save, be it air or be it water, you can dip into your savings for a later day. Your ATM is going to run dry if you're not going to put money into it. If I'm not going to provide trees and a proper river for my children, tomorrow if they're going to turn around and tell me, Amma, you have given me everything. You have given me a house, you give me a couple of houses, you give me a fat bank balance, you have everything, you have given me everything that money can buy. But I need a glass of water. I'm thirsty, I'm dying. I need air, I can't breathe. Give me air. Do you think I can have a clear conscience? No. Because I have watched that river die. I have watched that river, which was given to me by my great-grandmom and my grandmom and my mom, I have just neglected her. I have just thrown garbage into her. I have thrown my sewage into her. I have done everything possible to ruin her. And do you think how long can she bear the pain? How long? She's still struggling. She's still struggling to give you that water. She's still struggling with all the trees chopped. She's still struggling to give you air. Why are we not taking charge? Ladies and gentlemen, a social impact we would have created if we can tell people every tree is precious. Every drop of water that falls on earth, on this soil of ours, is precious. Let's save it. Let's not take it for granted. Just look at the amount of water that is just going for waste when it rains. literally going down the drain. It's all good water which goes into your sewage dumps, which goes into your sewage drains. Where do you get fresh water? So is it not the responsibility of each one of us to save that precious drop of water? Not only for ourselves, but our future generations. And that is the only thing that we can truly say that we have done to live. If you want to create, if you want to leave a footprint on the sands of time, the only thing that you can do is to leave the world a better place for your future generations. I take this opportunity to thank every one of you, to thank the Bharatiyar University, to thank the Bharatiyar School of Management and the Bharatiyar MED Alumni Association for this award, which I promise that I shall work till the end of my life to make myself worthy of it. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. There's no one better to deserve this award.
Wonderful speech, ma'am. In fact, after this program, we have requested Ms. Vanita Mohan and our chief guest, Dr. Atreya sir, to plant saplings in our campus. So this is going to be a beginning for Bharatiyar University, ma'am.
Leadership is not about glorious crowning acts. It's about keeping your team focused on a goal and motivating their best to achieve it, especially when the stakes are high and the consequences really matter. It is about laying the groundwork for others' success and then standing back and letting them shine. Now, we kindly request Dr. Mrityunjan B. Athreya to present the memento for our director, BSMED, Dr. Vivekanandan, for over 30 years of excellence in teaching.
In fact, Dr. Director was a young man those days when we joined, and still he's young actually. So we always admire him as a hero in the film, you know. Hope all the alumni will really appreciate that. Okay, good. So in fact, he's going to retire this year, and we thought we'll just give a small felicitation, that too in the hands of the chief guest. So the says this, teacher who instilled in us the passion for learning, guide who made us battle ready for our corporate endeavors, motivator who kindled the entrepreneur within us, mentor whose principles we strive to emulate. We are grateful to our guru, Dr. K. Vivekanandan, by the BSMED Alumni Association. Once again, I request you.
Thank you, sir. Achievers have a can-do attitude that sets them apart from mere dreamers. Achievers are sold out to success, no matter the obstacles, and they are willing to put forth the efforts and pay the price of success. The words for the alumni are to be follows. Mr. S. Manigandan has over 17 years of experience in engineering, blast fiber machinery, and has built an acute knowledge on sustainability through renewable and natural fibers, and is a firm believer that we need the earth to survive while the earth can evolve even without us. He has had the privilege of being the youngest in the history of International Jute Study Group to present a paper on the future of jute in December 2003. And since then, he has had the luxury of interacting with the world's finest technologists from various countries all over the world. He has launched India's first crowd-funded e-bike, Spero, in the year 2016. Mr. Manigandan's thoughts on linking sustainability to electric mobility received a big push with the US consulate, Chennai, nominating him to be a part of a 4-member Indian delegation to US to learn US alternate energy practices. Now we call upon Dr. Mrityunjay B. Athreya to will present the award to Mr. S. Manigandan.
Mr. A. V. Ramachandran graduated from BSMED in 2002. During his first year, Mr. Ramachandran was elected as the VP of the BMA, and in the final year, he was interviewed by alumni to be the CEO to then consulting Wing Youth Corp. Mr. Ramachandran brought Coca-Cola to recruit on campus and joined them along with 6 others from BSMED. He moved on to work with the tobacco major ITC before starting his career in banking with ICICI Bank and then moved to work with Citibank. Mr. Ramachandran held positions from a relationship manager to handling a branch to handling a few branches before becoming a specialist in the commercial bank. In the interim, Mr. Ramachandran pursued a 1-year program at ISB. An avid business quizzer while at the B school, Mr. Ramachandran has won a few accolades for the school. We kindly request Padma Bhushan Dr. Mrityunjay B. Athreya to present the award to Mr. A. V. Ramachandran.
Ms. P. Geeta Priya passed out from BSMED in 2007. She started as a HR executive in L&T Infotech, cleared TN State Civil Service exams in 2014, securing second rank. She joined as a deputy collector at Erode District and as a revenue divisional officer and sub-divisional magistrate Kunnur, the Nilagiri District, and currently the personal assistant to collector for Nilagiri District. She has also won a gold medal in All India Best Glider Pilot Competition. Ms. Geeta Priya has been felicitated by the PM of India, Sri A.B. Vajpayee. We request Padma Bhushan Mrityunjay B. Athreya to present the award to Ms. P. Geeta Priya.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Srinivasan Ramachandran is a corporate trainer and business consultant. He owns Tricone Academy and People Point, and training and staffing as his passion. Spanning over 18 years for corporate and institutions across the business domains, he is a strong believer of experience learning methodology. He is certified designer and national trainer of the Junior Chamber International. He is offering training staffing services to corporates like HDFC, ICICI, Reliance, Airtel, Vodafone, Robert Bosch, and The Hindu. And for the colleges, RVS IMSR, Coimbatore, Sri Shankara B. School, Coimbatore, and also for some social organizations. Now, Dr. Mrityunjay Athreya will present the award to Mr. Srinivasan Ramachandran. Mr. Manu A. Rajan graduated from the BSMED's batch of 2002 with securing first class. His Bachelor in Commerce from CMS College of Science and Commerce in first class, he joined in the IDBI as officer trainee in 2002 and joined as the probationary officer in SBI in 2004. Presently, he is the Assistant Vice President, Area Credit Head in SME Department of Axis Bank in Coimbatore and Erode. He was certified Associate of Indian Institute of Bankers in 2006, certified in Trade Finance in 2007 by Indian Institute of Banking Finance. Now we kindly request Padma Bhushan Dr. Mrityunjan B. Atria to present the award to Mr. Manu A. Rajan.
Mr. Krishna Kumar pursued his MCOM in Government Arts College and completed his MBA from BSMED from 1993 at Birch. He started his entrepreneurial journey in 2006 after working for 12 years in the apparel industry. He also has his branch offices in Tirupur and overseas offices in London and Amsterdam. He also appears on behalf of reputed brands, retailers, supermarkets in UK, Europe and USA. He occurs customers as Levi's, Lee, Manchester United, Manchester City, Debenhams, Disney, etc. We request Padma Bhushan Dr. Mrityunjay B. Atreya to present the award to Mr. Krishna Kumar. Ms. Nitya Lakshmi did MBA at BSMED from the 2008 batch. After completing her graduation, she placed on Land and Marvel Chennai as a HR manager. After that, she moved on to the State Bank of India as an assistant manager in 2009. Now, she has been promoted as a branch manager for Salem branch. She also completed many certifications on banking and management field. She has more exposures on banking field. Also, her passion is on calligraphy, photography, dance, and fine arts. We request Dr. Padma Bhushan Mrityunjay B. Atreya to present the award to Ms. Nitya.
Mr. T. Palani Kumar graduated from BSMED in 1991. He got placed through campus recruitment through BSMED placement cell in Ms. Rajshree Sugars and Cement Chemicals Limited, Coimbatore, as a management trainee, project finance officer. Then he joined the same. He then joined the Indian Oil Corporation Limited at New Delhi as a management trainee and worked in various locations for the past 25 years in departments like general operation, LPG operation, LPG sales and retail sales as operation officer, sales officer, deputy manager, manager, senior manager, chief manager, and now as deputy general manager and is heading Salem DO for the past 3 years. We request Dr. Atreya to present the award to Mr. Palani Kumar.
Mr. UEM Dinesh Gupta passed out from BSMED at 2002 batch. His areas of exposures include business development, channel management, B2B and B2C sales, key account management. Mr. UEM Dinesh Gupta industrial exposure include FMCG, telecom, lubricants and tires. He also worked in companies like Coca-Cola, Nestle India Limited, Bharati Airtel Limited, Goodyear India Limited and ExxonMobil Lubricants Private Limited. We request Mr. Atharya to present the award to Mr. Dinesh Gupta.
Mr. Madan Mogan started off as a territory sales executive with Balsara Home Products selling Bubble and Meshwak toothpaste. Then he was recruited into the product management team of Finolex PVC pipes. He started the journey with Atom Systems Private Limited. He also worked for the Adopt System Inc., Google Inc. and Beyond Inc. He then moved on to the second startup, Protoss Technologies Private Limited. Wanting to keep moving on and had started working with a lot of startups, he again started working with 3NGV Consulting Private Limited that turned around more than 30 organizations over a period of 4 years and also raised about rupees 15 billion for the organizations. He is currently on a leadership role in finance and administration with JS AutoCast Foundry India Private Limited. Now I kindly request Padma Bhushan Dr. Mrityunjay Atharya to present the award to Mr. Madan Mohan. Dr. Nityanandan Devraj is currently the President and Country Director, Bradken India, a Hitachi Group, the company in the mining and construction machinery segment. He is a mechanical engineer with a doctorate in management science, experience in manufacturing from hardcore marketing to general management. Dr. Nitin has been as working for Group, LGI Group, Sanfis Group, Suzlon Energy Group, and L&T. Dr. Tin played a vital role in turning around a division and company large as benchmark has won awards level. He's a development minister of commerce in India. Policy committee institution All India Management Association Board of Studies in Premier Management Institutes. He was awarded Excellence Outstanding Alumni Award, PSG Sons Charities, CMA Gold Year, Best Management Award for the Region, the Best Management Student Award, and accolades at national level. He has also won the Mother Teresa of Excellent Managers by Dr. Atharya to present the award to Dr. Nityanandan.
Mr. Vignesh Kumaraswamy is from 2008 batch of BSMED. He was working with the Hindu publication for 3 years before starting his own designing company, Banyan Brand Communication. Now their services include brand consulting, brand naming, logo designing, packaging designing, website designing, and social media promotions. His clients include Chennai Gate Rice, Dinamala, The Hindu, GKNM Hospital, Advait Lakshmi Industries, Gem Equipments, Ideal Water Tanks, Aqua Group, Solo Universe, SRS Lungis. Now we request Mr. Atharya sir to present the award to Mr. Vignesh.
Mr. Vijay Sarathi from class of 1999 has successful stints with companies including ITC Standard Chartered in a career spanning over 14 years. He started Purple Ironing along with friends in June 2012.
with a vision to upgrade the laundry business by empowering local ironing entrepreneurs to pursue their profession with a dignity in a socially, environmentally, economically sustainable manner. With a wide 30-year Purple, from being a market pioneer, now launched services in Chennai to other cities. Fond memory includes that with consumer with Professor Pati, managerial economics with Professor Ajay Mathew, and information with Professor K. Vivaganandan. Now we author your award, Vijay Sarathi.
Mr. M. Kumar, BA from 2002, he has handled products such as corporate banking, SME banking, and retail banking. His areas of exposure include new client acquisitions, credit appraisal, and loan receivable management. Mr. M. Arun Kumar was employed as a senior manager at State Bank of India, manager at IDBI Bank, and as a deputy manager at ICICI. He started in 2015. Currently, syndication SME authorized distribution partners of major private banks and financial institutions. Now, I kindly request Dr. Mrityun Raya to present to Mr. Arun Kumar.
Mr. Karthikeyan Jawahar was from batch of 1998 of BSMED. His UG was BE in the core of mechanical engineering in the year 1996. He was certified financial planner by Financial Planning Standards Board of India 2008. He also was working as visiting faculty for colleges in Coimbatore. He started his career as management trainee in Serval Engineering Industries Limited, applications engineer of Mobile Preps Co. Limited, account manager of Communications Limited, president of marketing, Dr. and Chief of Aditya Medical Systems, Director of Finova Financial Solutions Private Limited, Financial Wealth Group, Director of Karma Innovations and Solutions Private Limited since May 2012. He has published a management book and written articles acclaiming greater critic. He has won the Gold Medal for Innovation 2009 of Science and Services Indian Stubbornness Incubator Association 2009. We kindly request Padma Bhushan Dr. Athreya to present the award to Karthikeyan Jawahar.
Now students are in a way of getting the students crackerjack demonstrated throughout the year. The students awards goes like the best prop goes to Teen Niveda of second MBA A. I kindly request Ms. Vanita Mohan ma'am to present the award. The award that has hyped our curiosity and made us to be on our toes for 12 months. Runners, A sir with 122 points.
Without no further ado, we call upon the winners of the overall house competition, SAIL, with 188 points. request?
Second batch of BSMD goes to Srinidhi N of second MBA B.
I'm not afraid of an army of lions led by a sheep. Army of lion. Outstanding of the 32nd batch of BSMED goes to S. Anand Bharathi of 2nd MBA.
ஈட்டும் பொருள் முயற்சி எண்ணி ஊட்டும் படித்தேட்டம் காணும் என்ன நிர்ணயம் செய்கிறதோ அதை தவிர வேறு எதுவும் நம்மிடம் சேராது. அதனால் அதை தவிர்த்து மற்றவரிடத்தில் மரியாதையை சம்பாதிப்போம். நல்வழி அவ்வையார்.
We kindly request to give the placement brochure, and Ms. Vanita ma'am will receive it. To release the placement, and Ms. Vanita ma'am will receive it.
The only way to do great work is to love what you do. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking, don't settle. Steve Jobs. Now, we call upon Mr. Manu A. Rajan on the dais.
Mohan. Dr. Saravana Selvan, Dr. K. Vivekanandan, Mr. S. M. Shankar, faculty member of BSMED, students of faculty and students of the university, my dear alumni, good morning to all of you. It was George Bernard Shaw who once said, "Everyone sees the world as it is and ask why, but I dream of a world as it should be and ask why not." This quote by Bernard Shaw sums up the legendary personality whom we have in our midst today. Padma Bhushan, Dr. Mrityunjay B. Atreya, missionary during the turbulent times of the 1950s, redefining the business landscape of this country and contributed immensely in rewriting it. He was consulting India much before the McKinsey's and the BCG's came to the country with their fancy jargons. He has got business vision and connected with various stakeholders in the Indian business community for the last 4 decades. His expertise has contributed immensely to both public sector and private sector enterprises in various sectors like oil and gas, power, fertilizer, steel, automobiles, health, etc. He has also taken keen interest in developing management education in the country and likes to provide inputs to management, teachers, scholars, and students. And that precisely explains his august presence at our university here too. Atreya say, started his education in the Tamil medium. When he was 16, his family moved to Chennai to take up his graduation in statistics, prestigious law. Graduation in 1960 and started his professional career as a junior cost accountant with the engineering firm Guest Keane Williams. He accounting cost accountant with gold medal in both intermediate and final courses. He continued his higher education in Stanford Business School in California before completing his doctorate in business administration from the world leader Harvard Business School with the aid of a scholarship from Ford Foundation. With such impeccable credentials, he was primed to take up a lucrative profession in any American multinational. But he found his calling, his motherland, of his country. He started at the Indian University of Calcutta in 1967, which laid shape to his future career as a management consultant. Dr. Atreya's consulting work faces it progressed along with the reforms of the Indian economy. During the 1970s, he was a consultant and associated with Indian Embassy. 1981, including IOC, ONGC, BHEL, SAIL, HMT, HAL, etc. By the 90s, with the advent of the liberalization era, he was advising to the Indian private sector, family, and entrepreneur groups. Dr. Atreya stressed with the public sector enterprise started when he was appointed as a member to the Committee of Reform and Restructuring of Indian Airlines in 1971 at the age of 30. Later, in 1972, he was called upon as a member to the committee to restructure the enterprise and cash flow. He also worked for the RBI committee of top executives of public sector banks, working with illustrious people like Dr. C. Rangarajan, Singh Aliwal, was at the head of the Committee on Indian Telecom Restructuring, constituted in 1991. It was called the Atreya. He chaired, which included M. Pitroda, Mr. N. Vithal, Dr. V. Krishnamurti, and late M. R. Pai. This committee was for the in the country, including areas. So if all of us are able to speak on our smartphones in any part of this country, then we should thank Dr. Atreya. In hindsight, the revolution spearhead is considered as the most successful reform in the sector in compared to power, trains, airport. He has also immensely contributed to the NGO segment, brought modern management sector. He was a founder president of Sampradan, the Indian Center for Philosophy, whose mission is to recreate a caring and sharing society. He is a firm believer of the pivotal role that NGOs play in building this country. He says the government cannot solve. And other the day, Anita Mohan definitely agreed to that point. Time would not put I would like to sum up a few. He was a visiting professor in London Business School and he was a chair professor at the age of 34 at Strathclyde Business School in Scotland. He was director of the management program for Indian CEOs held annually by the All India Management Association in Srinagar and Kashmir at the age of. He was given the Life Award by Dr. Shashi Tharoor, HRD Minister. And finally, to honor his exemplary service to the nation, conferred the third highest award of the country in the year 2014. What makes Dr. Atreya special is his emphasis on humanistic and incisive way of change. He stays away from the cliched jargons of management consultants by offering simpler and more recent way of doing business. He also draws heavy inspiration from the Vedanta philosophy and also pioneered the incorporation of the concepts of Bhagavad Gita and Upanishads in business management. He also quotes and follows the principles of Mahatma Gandhi, which he believes will solve the three major problems that the world faces today: terrorism. Introduction by referring an article on the I came across only admiration for and travels to his nostalgic train in his younger days. He further goes ahead writing about the strength of Indian race and also offering horn criticism. It is the closing lines of the article that interested me the most. He writes, and I quote, "I hope the article is considered. The strategies proposed in this article not against long-term growth interest. Not that I love the railways any less, but I love the nation more." Sums up Dr. Atreya and his stream of work: a global thinker, but a nationalist at heart, a person who teaches, preaches, and practices the maxim, think global, but act local, a true patriot who believes that his Janmabhoomi, that is his place of birth, should be his Karmabhoomi, his place of work. Sir, it's a moment of pride for BSMED to have you amongst us today in this August gathering, and it's a privilege to hear from you. Thank you.
Let us make ourselves enthusiastically vibrant and extraordinarily curious for the pioneering management guru, Padma Bhushan Dr. Mrityunjay B. Atreya, to address the gathering on 21st century management challenges and the mission of the Indian MBA.
Yeah, very comfortable. Thank you. No, it's okay. Water. Yeah, we'll get a glass of water here. Yeah. Fellow guest, Shri Vanita Mohanji, the university, so eloquent this morning. I would like to compliment him on his inaugural address. He was very generous in his appreciation of the work of Vanita ji in the water development, being the mother of Coimbatore, as well as his explanation of Mrityunjaya Mahamantra. There is a story behind it. I was born at a time when our parents used to have large families. I was the ninth child of my parents. And my mother had conceived me, her health was poor. So father organized in the house every month a Mrityunjaya Homa. I was born as a big, healthy child without any complications, and therefore I was named Mrityunjaya because of all the events that took place at that time. And my professor, Father Murphy at Loyola, gave me the Latin equivalent of this name. In Latin, it is called Mortis Victor, victory over death, at least in concept. So I think the meaning I have taken from this is that we have to do the kind of work in our lifetime which is not selfish but social, and we will be not remembered for the behind sometime. We create of others who are imbued with these values who continue the work long after one generation has gone. I'd like to his illustration, the given him in recognition, a very productive peace retired life. I've seen this morning the beautiful house that he has built, very comfortable, but I'm sure that he will not be there. He will be productive and Coimbatore. I also appreciate the great strength of this business school and this university, that it has a very strong alumni association. There are 1,000 business schools in the country, and there are not many who have this kind of active alumni association. It is a very design, social impact, plus as well as alumni awards, and I'm sure later the student performance awards are coming. These are very important. These awards are a public recognition award. What is called the intrinsic side rather than the extrinsic of money awards, and this will inspire the rest to do more. Those who are to do this kind of recognition at some point of time. At the invitation of the business school, through the director as well as the alumni, we discussed various possibilities. We finally settled on this topic. I'd like this talk today and any questions and answers that follow to be useful to all the students here primarily and secondarily to the alumni. Not only teaching talk next week, month later, not only useful to you in your placement, but for useful to you for the next 5 to 15 years longer. You'll remember and reflect upon from time to time at certain turning points in your life and career. I'd like to speak of solving mission in the 21st century. There are three dimensions there. The 21st century India, we need to look at some of the salient aspects as it affects the profession of management and the challenges for management. So that's the second part. The Indian MBA, some of whom who are already in industry for the last 20, 25 years from BSMED, as well as the ones who are now about to qualify, those reflected in the placement brochure today, as well as the first year students who are here from BSMED, as well as the other business schools around Coimbatore. Third is a mission in 1990. The first batch of MBAs graduated in 66. 4 or 5 years down the line, I spoke about that the MBA to the IIT or one of the other engineering colleges graduates or other university graduates don't, which we, but that moving locally as the environment changes, as the country changes, as the world changes. So I'd like to recognize here the Bharatiyar University, on whose campus we are, the BSMED, which is a part of the university, the Alumni Association, which is energizing and backing up the institute. So this is a broad content, 5 frames, and that itself is quite a lot to cover. Each frame has about 4 or 5, so that's when those bullets. I closely with me. Think about it, and if there are any questions, comments later, I would welcome them. So the core mission of the MBA, what is the need for an MBA? Can management be taught? Is it something that one should do? So engineering or sales, somebody comes into management, but MBA has something unique and different to contribute. That is to professionalize management, just like no one can enter the medical profession without a medical degree, or you cannot practice law without a legal degree. IIM, in the thousands of business schools in the country, is that management should also be a profession. What is a profession? Profession has three dimensions, and which are distinct. If one goes through that profession, third, that goes along with that profession. For example, the medical profession has the Hippocratic Oath. Management, the values are embedded in this mission here. Professional management from a common sense kind of approach to a more systematic, concept, knowledge-driven process. All organizations, originally the concept of management was tied too closely with capitalism, private business companies. It still is relevant to them, but not only relevant to them. People like Peter Drucker and many others have talked about the power of management also in non-profit organizations. So I think I keep emphasizing that non-profits are to be even more efficient. They're even resources and 30 rupees longer. So doing good is no excuse for being sloppy or inefficient. In fact, you have to be efficient to be a business when their person contribute more. Finally, that management and that one of the young ladies, collectors of the management concierge administrative stream as well. And there are many MBAs from the IIM Calcutta and other streams who have in fact gone into the IAS profession as well. And the professionalism of management is to not only meet, satisfy, but exceed the expectations of multiple stakeholders. And by now, I think universally all over India in corporate governance, we recognize four stakeholders, important stakeholders. The paradigm shift after 1991 recognized and most important stakeholder, not the owner, not the government, not those in authority, but the person who pays revenue. Goes down, then any amount of investment not help the business, not finance increase losses on the business. So the customer investor. Any growing business needs external capital as well. The stock market, thriving capital market in India today to be able to attract additional investment, both institutional investors as well as ordinary shareholders. One of the big changes taking place in India today is the enormous growth of mutual funds, which have specialized, competent people, so that the individual shareholder is making money, especially on research-based mutual funds. Savings are moving in a big way from banking into mutual funds, from others like jewelry, way to go. The investors are companies which have which perform and pay regular dividends. The third is the employee within the organization, covered with and necessary discipline and productivity. And finally, the society. So the customer, investor, employee, and society. So the manager has to take the view of Mahatma Gandhiji as a trustee that his own rewards will be justified only to the extent that he meets these expectations and exceeds them. This has to be done no longer in a stable environment. Continuously, the environment is rapidly changing. Some of you may have heard of a phrase called VUCA, V-U-C-A. We were discussing it yesterday, session in the morning. The directors, again, we had a very fascinating discussion on the changing profile of students, the needs, and the business between them, this of conversion. This environment, VUCA, stands for volatile, uncertain, competitive, and ambiguous environment. The concept I heard about in PE environment and methodology, that is political, economic, social, and technological. Now in Raipur, we have to deeply worry about the environment in which Vanita ji is doing great work, that is a physical environment. The environment of the world is changing. And that will affect business, the consumer, people, life in all ways. And so business has to factor in. Companies like Unilever already have done this. Sustainable development goals, integration is part of their business mission, and they factor the costs business model. This has to be done of an strategic thing as opposed to bring somehow managing one crisis to another. Going by purely intuition and improvisation, the idea here is to be strategic, long-term, 3 to 5 year thinking. Through people, through systematical systems, planning, information, operation, control systems, and processes which are reliable, which can be guaranteed, which can be audited, and periodically improved. This is the always continuing. The evolving we're talking about is to add on top of this additional challenges that come. So this is the environment. I was talking about very quickly. I had different frames on these. We don't have presentation to that presentation was entirely on the environment. The physical is changing already. This not only in North India, but summer 5 degrees hotter than previously. Rainfalls have been coming down. And now we will have unpredictable weather patterns, whereas agriculture needs a stable pattern of rains in winter as well as in summer. The political environment of the world has suddenly become more adverse than about 20 years ago. You may remember a book which came out after the Soviet perestroika called The End of History. The book was a book found the two the solution to the world and all countries, the same concept is applicable, a competitive market regulated by government, pragmatic based on China, North Korea, many questions are opened up, and it is not agreed that democracy will succeed in all countries at all times. Therefore, the world has a very which can freedom and development can go together with equality and equity for the people. The economic environment has become more fair. The 2008 recession was a big hit, but the world has recovered from it. And at the moment, the US and European economies and India is expected to grow faster at 8% plus from next year. But in the economic environment, there is one major problem. That is the challenge to the WTO, globalization, the world trading system. Countries are putting up more tariff barriers. They are going for bilateral trade agreements back to the pre-WTO system. They're going for multilateral involving only countries, but not all the 192 members of the United Nations. Environment is getting more rising. There is a trend towards right-wing leadership in many countries who are against immigration, want to protect their own country for themselves, and even pay an economic cost for this process. So the election of President Trump, Brexit, election of right Germany, is Merkel has had to admit a right-wing party into her cabinet. Parliament seriously predictable. Artificial intelligence, machine learning, robots, and now space technology. Some of it is very positive. Technology always has been a double-edged sword, positive side as well, negative. And there's now a serious discussion about the ethics of technology, a philosophy of technology, how government should regulate and control. So the MBA, starting today, the learning has only begun. And the alumni, as well as the current graduates, need to be learning throughout their life. What has kept me alive and young and relevant in this country is that whatever I have learned at Stanford and Harvard was relevant at that time. Parts of the concepts continue to be relevant, But the environment is constantly changing, so I have to keep up not only with the Indian environment, the Asian environment, the global environment. At least in your particular field, as a consultant, I have to kept up in all the fields, technology, quality. That's the advisor, the full manager should at least in his field, if you are, you should be well with the around the world, innovation, what are they doing, what are challenges. If you are a CTO, chief technical officer, similarly benchmark with IBM, Google, Facebook, so on. So our challenge is to be how to live in a developing country and have the access to all the ideas, concepts in the world. So India's new challenges, there are several. I have picked four or five out of those as the A category. ABC analysis is always relevant in the Pareto rule of 80-20. So reducing climate challenges has become today. India recognized this. We were an early signatory to the Kyoto Protocol, Montreal Protocol. We were in the Rio Conference in 1992. And even now, after the Paris Agreement, despite the US government's antipathy, we along with other countries are committed and want to do more than our obligations because it is our enlightened self-interest to protect this country. This should be done not nationally as its role. And in that context, I think the social leadership of people is very important. Inaugurate change festival in 10th February, and the idea was to involve college students, teachers, members of the public around in understanding the impact of climate. And I asked many of the senior people there, Tamil climate change. They didn't know the Tamil term. Then one young school student community gave us Tamil translation. I'd like to check it with you. Paruva Matram, that is climate change. I was aware of this. Every taluk village location, in every language. Recently, 3 months, monthly, how many to Tamil translation every evening at 8 p.m. that same Sunday it is given. Please listen to it. I'm glad that very few of you are listening. More of you should listen. 3 months ago he said, Swachh Bharat campaign, the Clean India campaign. The Swachh Bharat campaign cannot be made a success by 1,000 Mahatma Gandhis. It cannot be made a success by 1 lakh Narendra Modis. The campaign can succeed only if 1.3 billion Indians take up on Make India. Leadership is required, but as she had her own team, Bharathiara University, Annamalai University, many other. So we have a chance. Those of you to make you more responsible and spend their CSR budget, part of it on the climate change issues. But also make your company processes, products, carbon positive. We have their job creation. We have 10 to 12 million youth coming up every year into the population. I've been talking about it in every forum. I spoke about it yesterday on both occasions with the professors as well as at CII. This is a major challenge for us, creating jobs, both in the main company, in dealers in the industry, and self-employment, women's self-help groups, cooperatives, khadi. In various ways, we have to find jobs. People coming in. One of the problems that rises high economic growth is that executive compensation rises employee compensation. The systems are all behind the people levels. It makes some sense. They are driven. They take ownership. They do it. But your book, I hope it is in your library. At least the faculty should have read it. I hope some of the second year students have read it. If not, please go take a look at it. By Thomas Piketty, a book called Capital in the 21st Century. Many people thought that the problem of capitalism is over, Marx is no longer relevant. Piketty says Marx's revolution is not relevant, but the problem he raised is still relevant. The main argument in that book is that rises at a faster rate than the wages for labor. So even if the difference to compound 50 significant difference between the rewards to capital and the returns to labor. And that is why you find worldwide there is more inequality. The new technology, automation, increases inequality. Even executive jobs will get automated, learning machines. Newer ways, human judgment, feelings, cannot be replicated in the machine. So humans are always relevant, but we have to find new roles, new ways of doing it. Government is trying to deal with this social inequality. And one major step is called UHS, Universal Health Insurance. And in this budget, Swastha Bharat, the Healthy Indian, National Health Insurance Scheme that has been brought in, 5 lakhs in this direction. We also have to recognize China is at our border. In Doklam, it is with Pakistan with huge projects. It came for Arunachal Pradesh, the whole country. That's a significant change. This is Himalayas that will be deeply the entire Indian plain and peninsula. We are well behind China in technology as well as in economic growth, exports, foreign exchange balances. So we have. Last is that we have to keep innovating in 3 kinds of technology: business technology, as well as social technology, like in rainwater harvesting, revival of water bodies, and in various other ways, we have to revive our indigenous technology. And thirdly, for defense technology, it's also very important. We've been buying all the time, and that is a continuous dependence. And not give us the latest technology. Therefore, we have to do it. And the recent visit of Defense Minister Nirmala Sita and the end of a defense corridor connecting Chennai with 4 major industrial clusters, including Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu, is a major. And some MBS to go into that. Okay. Right. Now, in the context of this environment and challenges before India, I would like to identify what are the additional elements of the mission of the MBA beyond the core mission, which will always continue, which we saw. So the enlarged MBA mission, many dimensions. One, we now have to go not only growth and profits at any cost, we cannot afford to do that. We should put the sustainable environmental costs onto our balance sheet and profit and loss account. So sustainable business growth and profit. We should not go helter-skelter in a way that it profits the business but damages the environment. What is called externalities in economic cost. Governments cannot be policing, tracking, taxing all these. Sometimes people take over and stop projects from taking place, like the POSCO steel plant in So every company should, within its own calculus, keep in mind that it should be beneficial to the environment rather than damaging. Earlier in Coca-Cola, taking water from Kerala and other places, and now they have been compelled worldwide, Coke and Pepsi, to go into more harmonious products, fruit juices and snacks for health, and the cola consumption is going down quite rightly. Maximize job choice of technology. We should keep by raising motivation and productivity, make the human being as competitive, as good, if not better, than expensive machines. So automation should be done for recency, which can be achieved only with machines. But wherever we can use human labor, appropriately strategy, motivation, and so on. we should moderate the disparities in the executive compensation and maybe vest the stock options for longer periods, increase the share of wages in the value added sharing. Every year the business adds value, part of it will go in tax on the customers, the product improvements, positive part of it will go to tax the shareholders, but the share of labor also has to rise reasonably ahead of inflation so that their own standards of life protected, own a modest home, have some savings for their old age. One issue we have to factor in is a very positive factor from a health point of view, but it is a business challenge. Life expectancy is going up. When I was in college, the retirement age was 55. Not only in government, but even in a company like ITC. And then they found that 55 people were still in very good health. We are wasting experience and knowledge and wisdom that they have gathered. It went to 58, it went to 60. In central government now it is 62. In the Tata Group they have a policy, if you become a director of a company, it is 65. If you become chairman of a group company, it is 70. For the Tata Group level chairman, it is 75. So the it is going up. People have a lot of their former ends. So senior citizens should be able to look after themselves. Families are becoming smaller, two children or one child. Family, creation of talents. See the phenomenon of lonely, uncared for parents, a little less in some Tamil. The more plays as this is increasing, and old age homes are coming up. Almost like one of my friends said, that you are in the lounge waiting for your last flight out of this planet. That is why these senior citizens' homes are. Therefore, enabling people to plan a comfortable post-retirement as well, bring up their children, educate them. And this new mission has to focus it for a long interest of employment. So we have to catch up with nations which are becoming more and more productive. China is now raising productivity and growth, and benchmark is not comparison within India. We cannot satisfaction that we are growing better than that industry, we are going better than that country, we are a better somebody else, we are a better company within our state. All that is good, positive, but we have to really globally benchmark and see how the business responsibility now is equivalent almost to the political responsibility. The political leadership has to take care of the country's democratic stability, defense and so on, foreign policy. Business has actually to be the main engine of the economic growth and security. And the less business gives in taxes, more it does directly for the people, there will be less corruption, leakage, and efficiency. We also have to the latest technology, not continue to society, become innovative. Indian technology, brands, etc. must be sought after in the world. To conclude with an action plan for senior MBAs as well as the new MBAs, and then invite your thoughts and questions. This is what I did when I finished in Loyola, and I'd like to recommend it to you. Don't plan for your first job. Don't just think in terms of promotions of the next two, three levels. Think of your life. Why am I here in this world? What opportunities I have got, others have had, how my parents' circumstances, my own efforts. I have done class 12, I have done an undergraduate degree. I now got an A from a... Stop learning. This knowledge will be obsolete in the next 3 to 5 years. So lifelong learning, you must have... And you need two satisfactions in life to be a good human being. One is professional job satisfaction in your career, and the second is a life satisfaction, worthwhile life. And now my body, mind are failing, my time will go. I have no regrets. Leaving behind, which is deep.
honorable, productive to my fullest potential I have utilized and delivered. So you need to have some kind of a life mission. It is not the money, bonus, all that will come. No comparisons. There are two rules here. However much you earn in the world, there will always be somebody who earns more than you. However less you earn, there will always be some people who earn less than you. So don't and make you miserable. Do something better. Earn enough for your family, plenty for holidays and so on, but your potential, leadership, managerial skills, you are being at the very unique education. It's understood, is as good as a medical education or a legal education. It's a very powerful tool that you are taking with you. And even in the case of successful managers, I find that they have not fully exploited all the elements of this model. I'm constantly dissatisfied with my work. Be dissatisfied with your contribution. Don't be dissatisfied with your rewards. Take care of your follow. Where will you go? You don't have to worry. It cannot run away from you. The country will recognize you, professional. So, what do I want to do with this life? Like Vivekananda, Adi Shankara, many other people, Mandela, many that we have right now, dedicated people leading in various fields. So what is the leave behind business that blessing? The second is even though you are in a job in a big company, I think this is a concept, family. It's like Coimbatore. You are very Coimbatore, a culture. Therefore, either family leadership taken by the bacteria of entrepreneurship. This is what company levers Tata Group have been using, is that even within a big company, entrepreneurs are needed. One chairman, one board cannot drive. Even or says they don't have a single IT business. They have businesses in different sectors, different kinds of businesses, products and services, on site, off site. There are many divisions within the they need internal entrepreneurs. There is a term used to describe them. So you have to become the owner of the business, take charge of the business. And when I speak to younger MBAs between the age group of 25 and 40 in many companies, I tell them in the presence of the top management, the presence of chairman and directors, this company belongs more to you than to them. That time will be up earlier. They will leave. So it is in your self-interest to make sure that this organization progresses, is efficient. Even if they make some to forgive, they have made some life will your team and your in the organization. I'll ask simple question: what is the arm produced it from team? If you can, what age will you take total responsibility for your life, career, profession, and everybody else? All is to you, and all difficulties are because of some other's life. We set that and initiate division of the head is the businessman, and he has to think and act like a business person, run with it. Who will be in charge? Planning, leadership pipeline, long run coming to the top management. So, which combines entrepreneurship, imbibe qualities. The key difference is probably that in the entrepreneurship, you deliberately are taking risks. But the management concept, prevention and management in the business. person to the MBA, some risk and by God's very extra turn of events, the success of the career, enough intra experience, and you feel very confident, and you come out and entrepreneur on your own. Find you more successful entrepreneur very quickly. It's not 100% as well. Back, bring out the entrepreneur as well as be then the best. That is a striving. It's not possible. Olympic English champion, cricket champion, all continue. Satisfaction, they've experienced the pinnacle, and that will keep too far below the peaks of achievement. So you have to globally benchmark with the best. That means a reading habit, reading journals, the net, following what is happening latest in your field. In if I read the right to be able to the latest taking place in the corporate environment. And if you are in, given the past going always for licensing, the royalty costs are rising. In multinational flow, there are technology brands and some go down because of the payment company abroad. You have to bring country. This is the action to leave. Just go back and review this, what we have done. So we have started a mission. So we'll afford it. Much of this is fully far remains to which I should give to that in the I take missions equal perspective transit from beer to a big manager, general manager, and from looking at general manager, top manager, looking at the whole diversified company. What is the signal computer is giving us? That it is time for discussion. Time for your questions. Yeah.
I'm so proud to ask a question to you, sir. I'm very honored. Sir, I have two questions. First question is...
ask one question and then second question. Yeah, don't strain my memory. Yeah.
Sure, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, unemployment... vastly prominent in all parts of India, sir. We know that only toppers of every college get higher placement, higher salary packages, and they go to higher companies. Sir, what if all the students can be nurse level, then we are very... will be...
Well, you're saying 100% are left without...
students.
I understand. The democracy, the citizen, so you have political, and you also, if you can take that, if you don't take the next, take it, pay up. And if some other idea that you want to be a trader, independent. Yesterday, a young man who used to work in my office as secretary in Delhi, he has come and sit in Metropolitan. Delivery and sales agent to a number of companies. He's doing well. He's doing AM to happy. He's totally charged. He's in good health. So, to explore various alternatives. But we must also do something from the government side in how to placement also go through the economic cycle. I'm sure there have been years in BSMED that placement is a days, and there are companies who wanted MBAs and you don't have for them. This has the management. And there are you have some in 2030. Institute would have a policy. Not had been looked to the extent them and sending those biodata keeps them research the institute prepared for unemployment, continue the search job. When I finish I had done it and my employment job for at hospital in beach Chennai. My salary was 100 rupees for the first month. I have been received a nice admission. Salary was my mother handled the rest of it. We guess see and my salary those days good to work your take care and institute will net I think we have to take it as well. Should be doing
so can I ask my second question, sir?
So we will stop for a minute and say good morning. Father, thank you.
The question I'm so sorry. Second question actually upon for not going to ask it. So the second question, so we have done our management degree, we have all the managing qualities, skills and everything, and we can get placed and for to notice something in India every month we had cases against women, sir. Lot would women not safe in India. If you don't be have does in our entrepreneurs and managers, do they have, how can they consciously contribute of experience, say the point millions and having and not providing safety to our own women, sir, with your knowledge and what can be done being from the managers, what can be done
for what purpose,
for this, sir?
Women, yeah. It's a big issue. Familiar with what you call the Nirbhaya campaign? Yeah, it's a major campaign. It took the whole world. We came to in that. So recently, Indian problem worldwide. Sharing national of the most family for the male, even in nuclear family, is neglect. So revolution, really, in terms of the U, part of its development goals. One of the goals, let me mention, 50-50 by 2030. 50-50 by 2030. What does that mean? Board of worldwide India director men target government of India years ago that one woman very bold. Even that was not there. Some companies have applied with there is initiative of the family board, not on professional men. Contribution token. From the UN, Norway has already passed a law. Companies should 40% of the board. Companies are the reason educated. They are available, skilled, come into the company. Terms are very changes, even working is right, that doesn't displace men and women. Even in Europe and America, a level to be considered. So now, recently, women audience in depth, some of them were head of HR. My advice now, accelerate process the merits. Now we have some constraints as well known. For some countries paternity, yeah, some companies are giving full paid vacation for 6 months after delivery. So I think these kinds of steps will help. And women also should make an extra effort that during those periods keep in touch with the business, keep themselves updated, and not drop out. And women who take 6 years with children, entry will progress. So they may start smaller companies faster. They can also be into smaller ones, can become higher. But generally, it should be of the men in BAC, alumni as well as students, is that you have the dharma, you have to compensate for all your to women. I tell myself, all the family, that for patients, have to take and compensate for the injustice done to women for a long period of time. Well, ACS reservation that we have done in the country. Yeah. Huh.
Sir, it's a pretty longest going. I'm more of your technology as a sub. Creation of industry. Even our learning about industry, the way it has progressed elsewhere in the world, the way it is expected to progress in India, is going to take over at least 90% of the what an individual is doing now. Meaning 10% technology is replaced. Which is a core sector industry. It's called mother of all industries, foundry sector. Without which, sectors. Reminds how to make viable even form of technology in the world technology. See, I'm the budget, income, and employment time.
Sure. The industry talking about, some of you understand, is the advanced. So I think that before, to the extent, no option but to adopt technology. If you are 50 to 50, your output is exported, you have to be competitive with the best technology. So by all means, go for the technology. In those kinds of industries, automation is justified because it's a matter of survival. Without that, you won't survive. But your question is whether that will make 50% years. Tell you what is a broader is that you make a plan not only to grow in your new technology business, but you also make a plan HR will be made relevant. How many of them can be retrained or some other and your own HR department will act as a placement service that the institute has for its graduates. Treat them as your children or your graduates with you for 15 years, and skill development corporation, sector-wise skill development corporation, find out where they can be placed and place them. The other idea is that you yourself plan some strategic direction. One part is your high technology business getting automated, and if there is a member in your family or if there is a good senior manager who has the skills, open some other business as a risk reduction, diversification. If something happens in your main business, you've got something else to fall back upon, and employ these people in that diversification. In your two businesses, one will lower tech and one high tech. And the third solution is that if there are half a dozen very bright skill, real potential, usually invest, give them money, but a little money, and help them set up in the business and until they become own our people, objects buy from the market today. This is our just loyalty. Agree to no wage in Germany. Management care. So part of the growing, don't neglect the other children, replace them, redeploy them and resettle them and make some of them entrepreneurs. So these are the ways. There may still be a few left who don't want to do any of these things. Then give them a handsome voluntary retirement and let them go. They may opt to go back to their village, go back to farming, something else. You have done your dharma. You have offered them an opportunity and they have to. Yes, okay.
Presently, we have letters of marketing, HR, analytics, operation. Having gone through, I'm thinking, do you use more now than we're on natural resources? Management, non-profit organization management, or MSME management should be concentrate, you know, bring in more verticals or should we?
That's a very good question, very good suggestion. Climate change and environment you can club together. So I think certainly a specialization in climate change management in the second year as an area where they can concentrate 4 to 6 courses and so get an MBA with a focus on environmental management. That another strong NGO management, that's also worth doing, where you'll go into the questions of NGO governance, NGO motivation, compensation, NGO accountability, fundraising skills and techniques. That is worth doing. And you may consider another, being in an area like Coimbatore, R&D management, technology management. Yes, I think these are worth considering.
Very good. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. And the alumni can help in this process in technology management with their experience. Those companies which are doing very well can be guest speakers. Projects can be done with the mutual benefit. Students will work free, learn, and the company will benefit. Yeah.
Sir, thank you for a wonderful session. Points that you're as the future need to do that in our
company. This usually happens. These are already in the best practices, and people and we more company.
Proud. Some of the things in the last have got 300% salaries. Whereas as promoters of the company, we
are that's very good. Because they're big. Even the 300 bring them anywhere.
That is fine.
Their life is a great benefit to the country because in terms of macroeconomic power, spending in the hands of the employees, and you know the marginal utility theory, the percentage of their income, save their percentage of their income. So they will create the multiplier and job creation. Okay, yeah.
And again, we are using our own technology.
Okay.
With us.
Very good. Excellent. Okay.
My question to you is, like, today when we are approaching some of our larger OEMs like Bosch or the Tata Group or even the TVS Group, like, again, it's an extension of what Nitinji was asking. Mm. Like, the floor, when you say loading and unloading manually, it is like a cuss word inside their organization. So not only that, even the processing, they want artificial intelligence to be included in that. So we have only been reading about artificial intelligence and other things in other parts of the world.
It is coming
but
here.
It is now asked, rather demanded from us.
It is real.
It is real today in our sector at least.
Right.
So what do you see as the future? I just think that is happening.
Is the leader in Indian plain the economic and cultural of this and assurance the packaging dispatch will be perfect, meet their standards, there will be no it will be under even the wages time plan, a multi-year time plan, as wages use more unloading. So you give them a for their satisfaction, a roadmap, but slow it as much as accelerate. So they are satisfied. So we have to stand as a boundary between their obsession with technology because they have shortage of labor. They are getting decline from a million in 25 years. Japan is already a stable population. So for them, automation of everything makes sense. Even the whole robot is Japanese now. So we have to justify, but you must guarantee. So then you have another dialogue with your workers that, look, this is what I'm doing on your behalf. You have to help me by delivering high quality packaging and handling, no damage to the equipment. It should arrive at the destination in good order. So I think that kind of a mediation role you need to play. But also to equip them mentally to be prepared that automation will come at some point of time. And along with your HR training program, your factories in Coimbatore and elsewhere in India, I have sold machine tool. With CNC machines. And then later it got replaced by automatic machines with software. So I saw a turbine blade in Haridwar, 22. It would automatically eliminate the labor. It was necessary quality, 800 rating. So you have to set up a mini automation training facility in your factory now, not for immediate use, but train people over the next 3 to 5 years that they will be ready to maintain, operate the more automated equipment. The rest of them may retire, or you replace them in some other job, and your expansion will take care of them, or you have to give them VRS at some point of time. So any problem that confronts you, management says, make a strategic plan, make a long-term plan, take one step, and gradually move forward. Yeah. Not let it paralyze us. Yeah.
So I have a query. So my name is Ram. And it's an honor to discuss this with you. It's more in continuation of one of my current year students who was actually posing a question of what if we could all get jobs, right? A slightly utopian perspective, some would say. And also a faculty member who was actually talking about introducing new courses. So my quick observation, and then I'll come with my question. We've had this query come in. So we've worked close to about 15 years in the industry. We keep going to campuses to recruit students. So the predominant feeling of what I get is that people are very surface. They operate your ilk much deeper than one could imagine. Even if I were to assume that that's only a small percentage relation back, even significant not having learned previous generation, not going in depth. While there is information overload, we have you know, technology really enabling us. In your era, there was no Google. We have other. Yes. We don't see actually go in depth because the current era wants people to go in depth, develop need, and not only talking about learning. Some of these companies that come to recruit are looking at MBA grads who have a good you know, orientation there. So I think more than introduction of new courses, the faculty members should actually prod students to go work with the industry, work very closely with the industries, so that people are aware as to the new, to become future ready, it's very important, rather than to blame the system that system is not getting us jobs.
Right, indeed.
So I think from that perspective, you just have to kind of give us an overview. My request is to give us an overview as the way things have changed from your era to now, and to be like, to be ready for 2030, for example. What, because these guys are going to be out next year, and they will look at their pinnacle of their careers with 35. Hear from you.
Yesterday, the director of management around the area, organized with the Alumni Association and the department. Very good. Remember. So, one of the broad the style time in the class, homework, the class. Discussions, questions, problem solving, sharing knowledge. That is one. Our faculty themselves should go out into the world. And in fact, it was very fortunate for me that I had worked for 4 years in industry in JKW Calcutta on the shop floor, shift work, and two nights a month I was on night shift duty as a supervisor for the whole factory. And all that made a lot of sense when I was going through my MBA and PhD at Harvard. Many academics come straight from colleges and PhDs into teaching. They themselves, in the MBA, know more about total multifunctional management than every individual the professor knows only her MBA picture. So at Harvard, it is a requirement that a professor should have themselves gone through an MBA or an MBA type 1 year training. So I think some of them need to go into industry in their own field, spend a BP and summer project to it. Time we may extend, instead of doing in the summer, there could be in management, materials management, whatever the interest in that area. I think this should be encouraged, and this alumni association network relate fully. Remember, for them, that initially, you may find it strange to go into a company, to go into a factory. I can read his video. The years of an engineer, a client, before I do any management consulting, I would request for a tour of the factory, tour of their warehouse, tour of one dealer workshop. Then come back and you can talk more sensibly about the business. You also pick up about steel technology, chemical technology, machine tools, automobiles, variety of things, and you can compare technologies and take technology management issues and lessons. So I think the teachers should also go through continuous education. They already have the theoretical side, more on the practical side. I think that we should work out in the annual plan. There are business schools abroad who operate like an industry. If industry has a performance appraisal system with goal setting at the beginning of the year, quarterly reviews, year-end appraisal, why not for faculty also? Between the dean and the faculty, an annual work plan, which should include the practical external world dimension. That may be useful. Yeah. But I think academics are highly individualistic people, and democracy bordering on anarchy is a tough place to run. Yeah.
Sir, as a banker, as a banker, it's kind
we may appreciate him for making a very creative introduction. He did his research and...
Thank you. As a banker, this question. You've been in a lot of banking committees with the RBI and all. Yeah, I was actually, you know, a banker. If that banking industry is going through, especially the public sector banking industry, is going through one of its most turbulent periods with mounting NPAs and all the new issues. What does you do and the way forward for Indian banking?
The public sector banks, managerial tax, so no banking, credit tracing, credit appraisal, and so on. As JRD said, many problems is that the owner is not professional. The government is an amateurish government. And there is a lot of political pulls to place for the motion, the right kind of posting and job and so on. So the solution is very clear, and I agree with that take. That gradually we should bring government ownership in public sector banks down towards 51% and make a strategic decision as to whether it's enough for government to retain three or four top banks like State Bank of India and two or three other banks for its own businesses and social purposes and so on, and at least the rest of the banks. Not even merge them under government ownership, because we have initial bankers in the private banks came from the state bank system, but many banks are doing very well, even in the stock market. All and domestic, they have sector banks, etc. banks. And if you look at one key parameter, the price earnings ratio, EPS price earnings ratio, the private banks are essentially higher than the public sector banks. Even if you have a bottom line reporting profit, the state bank share is valued at 10 times the, and the quote banks are times the earnings. So the mobile additional capital will go up if the bank is a private bank listed well. And government 2019 with the in that period, you privatization. Their mind is clear on the strategy. They are afraid to do it now, because they may lose the election. The public mind will be agitated, the press, opposition, even the managers will benefit. When we privatize, we should give an option to managers, owners, and they should also create wealth in the process of building these banks. And we now have enough Indian banks which have the capability to buy these public sector banks. Yeah. My own investment is in Kotak, HDFC, Karnataka Bank, Karur Vysya Bank. Yeah. Yeah. I want to invest in State Bank. The advice is no, don't. through it. Yeah. Yes. No, that, yes. Last two questions. That lady has put up her hand, so we will honor that. After you, one last. Huh?
Yes, like a fusion with Germany. And I put it to the notice that research which can talk about the environmental resources implement research into the consent of the adverse effect when the when lack due to robot. I that Germany for intelligence have been the fourth revolution,
mm-hmm.
industry revolution, and I want to take forth the research
mm-hmm.
like the
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I you want to do that? You see? Right. Okay. You see, my suggestion to this institute was not to do research in this area. That has to be done by technical institutions. R&D management training. Those who will go and manage the R&D there, they will have their outstanding specialists in that area of environment, pollution, air quality, participate matter, or greening the environment, agriculture, horticulture, silviculture. There are forest experts who will have that technology, you will help them in them. They are very in R&D, they are waste. We have labs, 40th lab, set up a committee of more XIAS officer, and his committee wrote a report which there was one sentence which was they wrote strongly. Research directors and scientists were unhappy that in our government, scientists perished, but perished. Very damaging comment. So then the approach, how to productionize R&D, how to take it into these skills they lack. They're purely single-track technical specialists. So whenever young people come to me and ask me advice on should I go for engineering or management, I tell them, if you have the time and money, first go for engineering, but certainly go for management. If you don't have the time and money, go only for management. As a manager, you can employ 100 engineers, but an engineer cannot employ 10 managers.
So I was very excited about the VUCA part that you spoke about. My company works in the area of VUCA leadership labs. So what I'm interested in is what is the gap you see between what the industry requires and the management and graduates have.
Mm-hmm.
What do we do to
changing even as a it has been my experience in the last 20 years that Indian managers and foreign managers who are in that industry which is changing very fast at the cutting edge know more about it than I do. Therefore, I have acting with them to be. If I am traveling as a consultant and I am behind, people who live in an institute campus naturally, even for what the institute is to him for every member in his or her area to spend some time in just applied research. No, not putting the changes that are taking place in the environment. So write a paper, write an article about one company, its environment, and room. Learn about environment in that field and bring it to the classroom. And it needs 1 week's time, maybe a few hours a day with some documents and some going to the net. So the in every class at Harvard, there is a belief that every 1 hour class should be preceded by 3-hour homework by the teacher. 3-hour homework by the teacher. Even if you have taught that subject for 10 years, because the subject is changing. Otherwise, you keep teaching what you taught also. So the teacher homework is very important, and half that homework should be outside the institute, not inside. So many of us in IIM Calcutta grew because we spent time out consulting and learning in the process. So it's a great advantage. Faculty can get paid as well as learn. I think they should jump at this opportunity. Yeah. Even if you go in training, executive training, in the classroom, in participative discussions, you contribute and you also learn in the process from the industry knowledge and experience. So the knowledge capital about technology and environment is in the industry, and we have to bring it to the campus. Yeah.
Sir, excuse me.
Yeah.
So good afternoon. Sir, I'm very happy about your principal, that is me, is Bhumi. But we are all about the population in the country. On the other size of population is moving from India abroad for job, and in the long run, they settle everything to engage. The government can do to retain this productive population in our country.
You see, the government is it. They've been trying for a long time to promote industrial growth, to ease, improve the ease of doing business in the country, improve the infrastructure. Government can do those things. Rest is for the industry to attract back this talent. Some industries are doing it. Two industries have done a great deal here. The pharmaceutical industry has attracted back a number of NRIs, PIOs, back to India to work with them. That does not mean that they have to live all the time in India. They have to go globally. But the base in India, so Sun Pharma, Reddy's, Cadila, various companies are bringing back NRIs. And the IT companies, Wipro, they're also the West session employment back. Is that is government is the Prime Minister? He speaks, and they for years now we've been celebrating a major 2-day event in Delhi of Pravasi, the NRI, inviting them also. By the commercial minister, that India has to improve the own home business. The foreigners will come and invest, NRIs will come back. So I think if they have an option that government to work, it is only. So when I have young batches now, I say, I don't tell them, don't go abroad, go abroad to qualify. Keep going abroad to learn, but bring it. You don't know it to let them have the joy and the satisfaction and thrill of being with the latest, but have this feeling that if I desert my country, what will become of these people? I think if they do it for 10 years, we are through, because our birth rates are falling. Our population is stabilizing. There are some states already where the net reproduction rate is below 1. Populations may decline. Tamil Nadu is one of them. So if we do it for 10 years and attract them back, but if we don't attract the generation and the kids, if the generation come here, goes down. Now, there's another idea which you can practice. We have found that the MBAs have stayed more in the country. 90% plus have stayed in the country. IIT engineers, 89. And the model to operate in this country. These must be component. Whenever a student has a good relationship with at least one professor in his MBA program or in college program, and he keeps corresponding with that professor. Probability of those students without in India more alienated. So responsibility of the lack of talent in touch with and triggering this thought of coming back to the country and maybe even look at opportunities for them, recommend them for some client companies and so on. So management teachers can play a role in reducing, preventing brain drain and bringing back the brains. Yeah. I still do. I'm in touch with a number of Indian MBAs abroad and they keep looking for and I to bring them back. Very good. Okay. Are you all hungry for lunch? Yeah?
We feel highly privileged for that exuberant speech. The discussion session with you was like traveling to a newer dimension of perception. Thank you, sir.
Success is never final. Success is never final. Failure is never fatal. It's courage wins.
Professor Matthew, and former director of BSMED, Dr. R. Venkatapathy, to present a memento as a token of love and gratitude to Padma Bhushan Dr. Mrityunjay B. Athreya. Athreya, present the memento to us.
Dr. Venkatapathy, sir, a retired professor, director of our BSMED, we are honored to have your presence, sir. Jai Matthew. Dr. Rupa Gunasilan. Dr. Sridharan. Dr. Malarmati. Dr. Krishnaraj. Dr. Barani. Dr. Ramanujam. Wait. Dr. Ramanujam, please. Dr. Madevi. Dr. Lingaraj. Dr. Priya. Dr. Ramkumar. And all the so it's really a great honor to get from the guru of all the gurus. Thank you so much. We are going to have a photo session, I mean, the alumni with the
Now chief I request guest, all of them. Now I kindly request all the award winners, alumni award winners on stage for the photo session.
I request all the alumni to come on stage, please. The alumni to please. After lunch, the alumni and the students and the faculty can come back and assemble here. We are going to have an interactive session. The alumni have a time to share their experience. I request alumni faculty to be. Thank you. lunch, all of you, request you from the fourth year, request volunteers from BSMED to guide them, please, and ensure they have been taken care properly. For the and the guest has been arranged.
We kindly request Nikan Narayan to give the vote of thanks.
Noon. We would like to raise our thanks to our chief guest, Padma Bhushan Dr. Mrityunjay Atreya, and our corporate awardee winner, Mrs. Vanita Mohan, Dr. Vivekanandan, Director, BSMED, Dr. Saravanan Selvam, Head of Department English Syndicate and our syndicate member, esteemed faculty members, our beloved retired professors, S.M. Shankar, President, BSMED Alumni Association, the Alumni Award winners, students from other B schools, students from BSMED, the ones who have won the award from our B school. Thank you all. Thanks to the team from Photo Boys who covered this event. Thanks to PA system. Served at the, let's, thank you.